upside down. Swear the roof is on the ground. Demons don't sleep at night. Oh, oh, oh. I try to turn off my mind. Say I'm doing just fine, but I'm screaming inside like, say these words on repeat while I'm trying to breathe. Now you're counting on me. So I fake a smile, but I know you know me too well. But it's alright, you're like heaven when I'm in hell. You were there, heavy heart. Tasted light, but fed the dark. I'm waiting for them all to see. I don't deserve your company. To love myself is way too hard. Try to turn off my mind. Say I'm doing just fine, but I'm screaming inside like, say these words on repeat while I'm trying to breathe. Now you're counting on me. So I fake a smile, but I know you know me too well. But it's alright, you're like heaven when I'm in hell.
Grubhub's getting rid of fees when you order McDonald's, Panda Express, and Panera. So now you can get McDonald's without the side of fees. And Panda Express without the fees. And Panera without the fee. You get the point. Only on
Grubhub! B-Dub's win-win value lineup gives you more with buy one, get one free Wing Tuesdays and Boneless Thursdays. Wing bundles starting at $9.99 and $3 Tall House beers. It's like finding a heads-up penny under a bag of diamonds. Buffalo Wild Wings. Get takeout or delivery.
Got your food.
Wow, tough year, huh?
Yeah, but not anymore. I mean, Grubhub's here, and so am I, so ready to DJ.
Come on in.
Thanks.
How's it going? I'm Dylan Francis. Welcome to Grubhub Soundbites live stream. It's going to be a beautiful night. We're going to be vibing. Got my nice couple that I delivered food to earlier. Say hi to them. Hi. Let's get into it. Let's get into it. And if you haven't already, make sure you order some food from Grubhub and eat with us.
We'll be right back.
How's my beautiful couple doing? You guys are doing good? Amazing.
Manager.
How you guys doing? You good? I wanted to ask you a quick question. What's your favorite thing about music and food? You don't have to answer, I know, because they go together so well. I'll be back later.
Always act and fake, don't appreciate.
changing the vibe. New grooves on the vinyl. We're breaking the cycle. Now, we're switching it up. We're making it right. New grooves on the vinyl. New grooves on the vinyl. New grooves on the vinyl.
Digestion song right here. She's like sheer vibes, perpetual vibes right here. So help your stomach. I got you. Don't worry. You don't have to worry about anything. Just keep enjoying the night. And you too. And you too. The moon will be here soon, don't worry. We can all dance. 6 feet away from each other though.
heart is feeling. Celebration tonight. Celebrate. Don't wait too late. No, we don't stop.
Fell in love with a white boy. He's my hot boy. Walk it out like a Broadway. Gotta get it what they all say. Everyone to get it what they all say. West side girls love me. East side girls love me. Down south girls trust me. You got something lovely. All I wanna do is let go, baby, grab a hold and lose control. Never question your morality. Gotta get through your sexuality. You don't gotta ask, take it from me.
Let it go.
guys can get up and dance if you want right here. I mean, it's a great song to dance to if you want. I know you're done eating. I'd love to see it. We'd all love to see it. Maybe we're gonna dance. Right here. That's beautiful. You can sit back down now. That was it. That was the only one I really wanted you guys to dance to. Now you can just relax and just watch me. Grubhub for having me here. Appreciate you for having me on the Soundbites. I got one more song to play for my beautiful friends over here that invited me to deliver them food and have a great time. We had a great time, right? Yeah, we did have a great time. But I love you, Grubhub, and I love all you watching. They just talking.
Is it alright if I come round? Is it too late if I come now? Would you stay up to figure this out some way? If I stay here, would you come back? If I stay cool, would you be mad? Would you want me if I want you that way? Cause all I can think about is coming over. All I can think about is coming over. All I can think about is coming over, coming over. Is coming over, all I can think about is coming over, all I can think about is coming over, coming over. Isn't it strange? Is coming over, all I can think about is coming over, all I can think about is coming over, coming over.
Again, thank you Grubhub for having me on the Soundbites. Just got to give a shout out to Sharon from Buffalo Wild Wings. She picks it up, gives me the ultimate amount of sauce. So Sharon, you're the best, okay? I love you. Wherever you are, I hope you're doing fantastic. You guys stick around. There's a live Q&A with me. I love you. I'll see you at the Q&A. Don't leave. We'll leave this, but go to the Q&A. Okay, bye. See ya at the Q&A.
What's up, everybody? Thanks for tuning in. Thanks, Grubhub, for putting this together. Now it's time for the Q&A section. So I'm ready to answer any questions you have about me, my life, the show I just played for the two people. Anything you want to ask. Anything you want to ask. Why is this in my recommend? That's a good question. It's because, you know, food and Dylan Francis bring people together. And so they recommended that to you. That's an easy question. Next one. Dylan, how many times has Gerald been replaced? That's a good question. I probably around like 25 times, I would say, sadly. Do I even lift, bro? No, I haven't been to a gym in so long. I forgot what it's like. My road to one ab is completely gone. But I'll restart it once I can go back. Gerald, how is Gerald? Oh yeah, I forgot. I need to say the people's names and questions. My bad. So Joel O says dream venue to perform at. I think Coachella was actually already one of those. So that already did it. Thank you, Coachella. I love you. I think I played it three times. Splam 52 asked how Gerald is, and you know, he's vibing in the back somewhere in the car. Candace Mallard says, how did you go about learning to produce your own music? That's actually a good story. My friend Corey Enemy, I think that's what he still goes by, but he was this incredible producer, is this incredible producer. Not was, still is. He is an incredible producer. And I had met him in LA, and I knew that he worked in Atlanta. And I asked him if I could become his assistant and learn how to make music from him. So he's like, if you can fly yourself out to Atlanta, you can live on my kitchen floor and I will teach you, and you just have to be my assistant. And that's what I did. And I stayed with him for 3 months or 2 months or something like that. And then I moved back to LA and paid my parents the rent money and to stay in their back house. And I asked them if they would let me live there for a year and see if I could make anything happen. And boom, here I am playing sound bites for Grubhub. And so, you know, anything's possible if you put your mind to it. And I know that a lot of people say that, but that's very true. Put your blinders on too, and turn off all your social media stuff and just focus on your craft. Elizabeth J says, favorite place to play a show at? I think I would have to say LA, because I'm an LA native. I've born and raised. And then I would also have to say Norway. That was like the one place that I asked my booking agents when I got my booking agents in Europe. Shout out Belinda Law. She's incredible. I've been working with her for like 12 years now. And I asked her to book me a show in Norway. And she was like, you got it. And I think I played to like, you know, maybe 100 people. And it was just incredible. And I just kept going back. And I built an audience there. Really ground roots stuff. And I didn't care how many people I was playing to when I was going there, because I just wanted to see it. And it's beautiful, especially in the summertime. All right, let's see what other questions we have. Aaron Warner says, thinking process while making music. My best advice, even if you're not asking for advice, I'm just going to say this because this is my process. So when you're trying to sit down and make a song, it may happen or it may not. So the best thing to do, if it's not happening, if you're not able to make a song that day, then the best thing to do is make loops, like 10-second loops of sounds. Go into your synths and make stupid noises. Don't focus on making anything but noises or drum loops. That's it. And then come back to it tomorrow and you'll have these little loops that you can maybe splice together and get them in the correct key. And you'll end up making a song from those inspiring little loops that you made yesterday without focusing on what you should make. Yolanda Liggins says, what's your favorite song? What's my favorite song right now? What's my favorite song? She didn't say right now. So I would say my favorite song ever would be Sam Cooke. I'm forgetting the name right now. It's on the tip of my tongue. I don't want to say the wrong name. I keep thinking of the song where it's like, darling, you thrill me. But that's not it. That's not it. It's A Change Gonna Come. That's what it is. Sam Cooke, A Change Is Gonna Come. That's one of my favorite songs. Aiden Game says, how old are you? I am 33 now. I've been making music for 15 years now. Holy. Time flies when you are touring, even though I haven't been for a bit. Have you tried doing I need to read the names. I got to keep remembering this. Kristen Rodolfo. Wait, no, I'm saying this wrong. Kristen Rodolfo. No, I'm saying it right. Any pets? No, sadly. Well, my parents have a dog. But I had a cat and I gave them my cat, and sadly, I think it was like 2 years ago on Halloween, he got out and was never seen again. I'm hoping that some other family picked him up and were like, they thought it was a lost cat and he's doing good now. So that's what I'm going to think. David Clark, please don't spam, but I'll answer your question. Have you been to New York City? Wow. Yes, I've played there a bunch. Great question. Great question, David Clark. Wow. Thrilling. This is a good one though. JJ De La Torre says boxers or briefs. And I'm going to have to say boxer briefs. I like the briefs and, yeah. 21 Jubilee says, are you an MMA fighter? No, I am not Dylan Danis or whatever, but everyone always tags me in his posts asking me why I'm trying to fight people. And that's not me. That is not me. I am not that guy. 3KG Twix says, what do you look forward to the most about summer? The shows. Summer is like the best time for playing shows. Hopefully by summertime, we're all going to be back out there at our favorite festivals and having the time of our lives. Midia Smelt says, have you met Alan Walker in real life? Yes, I have. I believe it was in Brazil for Lollapalooza. And he's a great dude. Isn't he from Norway? If I recall correctly, I think he's Norwegian. So shout out to him. And if I'm wrong, I know that he's from somewhere over there. So if I'm wrong, I'm sorry. But ZWUKY, I don't know how to say your name. What is your favorite DMB track at the moment? My favorite one is the one that I played at the end of my set, the Coming Over DMB remix. Shameless plug right here. It's going to be coming out April 16th with a bunch of other VIP remixes that I played in my Soundbites Grubhub mix. So there you go. When will Michael Scott? Oh, Michael Scott from The Office is in here. When will there be another Mad Decent boat party? Mad fam. I don't think that actually will ever happen. I think they're trying to do something where like everyone goes to Costa Rica or something like that. I don't know. I might be giving you guys too much alpha right here. But yeah. let's see. Some of these comments are going so fast. Okay. Aaron Van Noy says, what song are you most proud of making? That's a great question. I think my favorite song of mine would have to be Not Butter. Yeah, Not Butter by me, Dylan Francis, is my favorite song and my favorite music video I've ever made. So shout out Brandon Dermer. All right, last question, and then I'm going to wrap up, and you guys better stay tuned, okay? So the last question I'm going to do, okay, right here. Sir, it passed it. Never mind. Sorry, we can't answer your question. Oh, wait, no, I can see it now. Wait, back up. Let's see, where is it? It's, where are you? I think it's a, there it is. Sarita Bassnett says, what food do you hate most? And the reason that's a good question is because I hate tomatoes. And it's a good story. And this is the last thing I'll end on. And then we're going to go to Alan Walker. But when I was younger, my dad took me to his friend's house. And the guy had a tomato farm in his backyard. And the guy that had the tomato farm said, yo, Dylan, go and eat one of these tomatoes. And I was like, I don't like tomatoes. But I didn't say this to him because I was probably 10 or something. And I look at my dad and I'm like, damn, I don't want to disappoint my dad. I got to eat this tomato. So I grab a tomato from one of the things and I eat it. And it's all green and red inside. And it was awful. And I remember just chewing it and trying to be happy as possible. And when he asked me if it was good, I just did the, so good. And I didn't disappoint my dad that day, which was great. And my dad ended up later on telling me that I shouldn't have done that. And that's why I hate tomatoes and I can't eat them. And if I ever eat them, I think of that day. It flashes me back into it like the Matrix. But anyways, I'm done for now. Stay tuned for Alan Walker, delivered to you now. I got Grubhub jokes. All right. Love you, bye.
Hey everyone, I'm Alan Walker and I'm very excited to be invited by Grubhub for this soundbite session. So please do enjoy. Thank you.